Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to take a look at the constitutional isomers of cyclic systems. So we're starting out with a molecular formula, C6H12, that requires that I have a ring or a double bond. In this case, we're going to do cyclic systems. Okay, so the number of hydrogens is such that it is a cyclic system. And so the quickest way to get started here, if I'm trying to figure out the different constitutional isomers that I can make, is to start with the biggest ring possible. So since I have six carbons, I'm going to start with a six-membered ring. So just I'm drawing a hexagon here. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So that's my six carbons, and there's no end. It's not a chain, so everything is a CH2. So 2 times 6 is 12. I've got my 12 hydrogens as well, and I'm all set there for the right molecular formula for this constitutional isomer. Now there's only one way to draw that six-membered ring. So analogous to a chain that you draw, you can shrink the ring and start to look at the ways that you can put together smaller and smaller rings. So if I go from 6, the next step down would be 5, right? So I'd have a 5-membered ring, and then I can put the extra carbon outside of it. So it would be a methyl group right there. And so that would have 3 H's on it, but then the carbon that it's attached to is a methine. It would only have 1 H on it. All the remaining carbons inside the ring there would have 2 H's each on them. Those are all methylenes. And so again, you add up to your 12 hydrogens that you would expect, and I have a total still of 6 carbons. One's outside the ring, but I still have 6 carbons. Now there's only one way to put that methyl group on. It could be on any of those carbons and it would be the same thing, right? So it doesn't really matter where it is. And so I'm gonna have to shrink again if I wanna draw a new constitutional isomer. Okay, so the next step down then would be a 4-membered ring. So there's a number of different ways that I can do this. I have 4 carbons in my ring, which means I need 2 carbons outside. I could put one substituent that had 2 carbons in it, like that. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, right? And we already have checked several times. We know we have the 12 hydrogens we would expect. I could have a 4-membered ring that had 2 substituents, 2 methyl groups. They could be coming off the same carbon, like the example I've drawn there, or they could be coming off different carbons. You can pause it and see if you can figure out the next one. There's one more. That's where they are coming off opposite carbons from one another. So all of these are constitutional isomers with the molecular formula C6H12, and they all are 4-membered rings as well. Okay, so you can see that the larger the molecular formula gets, the more constitutional isomers there are. Lastly, I could even go all the way down to a 3-membered ring, which is just gonna look like a triangle. That would leave me 3 carbons outside the ring, so I could put them all on individual carbons. Or I could put 2 on one carbon and 1 on another carbon. And again, we have to be wary of, you know, duplicating. So for example, this guy is equal to the one above it. It's just a 180-degree flip of the molecule. So the connectivity really has to be different. You have to take a close look at that. So this has been a look at how to draw constitutional isomers for cyclic systems. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.